Vamos a hablar hoy con una persona muy especial, con uno de los maestros, de muchos maestros, Frank Gambale. Muy bien, Frank, muchas gracias por estar con nosotros.
Un placer.
Un placer, claro que sí. Let's talk about this amazing signature guitar.
Yes. Well, it took a couple of years to get it, actually not that long, about a year to get it right. We did 4 prototypes. This is actually the second prototype, which we ended up using as the definitive guitar that they copied. You know, I'm really happy to be in a position where I can help design guitars, because guitars are very, you know, we play them every day. It's great when companies will trust us to have the liberty to say, it needs to have this, it needs to have that. They want to elevate their image a little bit. That's why they came to me and they said, we want you to create our flagship, the top of the line acoustic guitar for them. And I said, okay. What a nice project. So personally, I've always liked classical guitar bodies.
Oh yeah.
Not the big dreadnoughts or to me, whenever I hear a steel string acoustic, the loudest ones seem to be the ones with the smallest bodies.
Yeah.
So that's what I went for with this. It's a classical guitar dimension.
Yeah.
With a cutaway because I like access to the frets. Apart from the woods, which are spruce top, I have Australian blackwood here on the back and sides.
Blackwood, yeah.
Australian blackwood. This looks a little bit like koa.
Oh, yeah.
But it's a lovely resonant wood. Ebony fretboard, rosewood neck, and a little veneer of ebony on the head of the headstock, too.
And your logo.
And my logo, of course. I have an 8-year-old daughter. She's always sticking things on my guitars.
Yeah.
And she gave me the idea to put this jewelry, even if it's not real diamonds. I'm sorry, they're not real. But it looks beautiful. I'm very particular about detail. This has, I mean, just a little, it has a black saddle. You'll see that every other one has, even all these guitars behind you have white saddles. To me, it sticks out. There's nothing white on a guitar.
Yeah.
To me, black is more pleasing to the eye because it follows, especially with the ebony and a black nut also. Very small detail, but to me, it looks more elegant this way.
Great.
The fretboard design, I wanted to do something different there. I didn't want just dots or squares or whatever. I wanted to create something unique. I'm a fan of Art Deco period.
Yeah.
I took a piece of jewelry that I found online and I stretched it out and it sort of became the basis of this long, beautiful shape on the fretboard.
Beautiful, yeah.
Still has dots on the side, so it doesn't confuse you when you're playing. Okay. I don't really see the fretboard when I'm playing. I see the side of the fretboard. But one of the things that Cort did that I had to really push for was, you know, whenever I get an acoustic guitar, I always set it up a particular way. And I was really wanting them to set it up this way from the factory.
Okay.
I had to push them because these are very light strings. This is a 10 gauge on top and I have plain third. At the NAMM show in LA this year when we released the guitar, I said to the interviewers, just like yourself, you could go right around this hall, there's thousands of acoustic guitars, and not one is set up like this from the factory. A lot of acoustic guitar manufacturers are afraid of fret buzz.
Yes.
You know, there's no fret buzz here. I mean, I don't hear fret buzz. To me, the guitar is alive, and this is only a 10 gauge on top, very light string. Still resonates beautifully, and with a plain third. But to get a factory to do it from the factory, even their factory said, no, we can't do it, we can't do it, we're afraid, there's going to be problems, blah, blah, blah. And I said, please do it. It'll be the first guitar ever to come from a factory set up properly, or at least for my tastes, you know.
Okay.
I'm primarily an electric guitarist. I love to play acoustic guitar, but I don't like an acoustic guitar with heavy strings. I just don't have the strength. Even after 50-something years of playing the guitar, I like it to be fun and easy.
Yeah.
chords, you know, bar chords. I want to be able to play it for hours without fatigue.
Okay.
So they did it.
Oh,
and
great.
People are picking it up. As soon as they pick it up, they realize, wow, this is different.
What about electronics?
I only gave them, I said one question to Court. I said, what does James Taylor use?
Okay.
And whatever he uses, put it in this guitar. Okay. And that's what we did. LR bags is the pickup. I figure, you know, you take an expert in the field and then you ask them what they use. Uh-huh. And so James Taylor uses the same LR bags pickup that's in this guitar.
Okay. Nice.
And it's very subtle. Yeah. And I love that the volume and tone are here. You can barely see them.
Yeah.
They're invisible. I didn't want the big on top, the control station up here. Besides, that's what you look down on when you're here, you know, when you're looking at the guitar. I just want to see a beautiful wood, a beautiful instrument.
Yeah.
So that's the electronics. That's pretty much it. It's just a beautifully made guitar, an elegant guitar.
Yeah.
I wanted an elegant, beautiful.
It is.
So I'm very, very happy with it.
Okay.
And the reviews have been spectacular, which is exactly as I expected, because it's really about the players. When a player picks it up, they know immediately that it's a great guitar.
Well, Frank, thank you very much for your time and for your attention.
You're very welcome.
So enjoy Madrid.
I will.
y que seas muy feliz.
Muy feliz. Sí.
Okay, eso.
Sí.
Si te ha gustado este vídeo, pulsa me gusta, compártelo y suscríbete a nuestro canal de YouTube. Hasta la próxima.